Hello friends, welcome to my channel Learning Electronics. In this lecture number 12 of root locus, we are going to study rule number 7 of drawing root locus, that is intersection of root locus with the imaginary axis. In the last class, we have studied the determination of breakaway point with the help of solved example. So if you want to see that video, you can check it in the description box below or you can go to the channel playlist. So before starting the video, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon so that you can get more updated videos from here. So now we will study the procedure to determine the intersection point of root locus with the imaginary axis. First step is to construct the characteristic equation of the system, that is 1 plus g of s into h of s is equal to 0. Second step is to construct the Routes array in terms of k. Third step is to determine the marginal value of k from the Routes array, which creates one of the rows of Routes array as row of zeros except s to the power 0 row. Fourth step is to construct the auxiliary equation A of s is equal to 0 using coefficients of row which is just above the row of zeros. Fifth step is to find the roots of the auxiliary equation for k marginal, which are the intersection points of the root locus with the imaginary axis. Before applying the steps of determining the intersection points of root locus with the imaginary axis, we have to remember certain important points. That is, if k marginal is positive value, then there is a valid intersection of root locus with the imaginary axis. That means if k marginal is positive, root locus intersects the imaginary axis. And if the k marginal is negative, then root locus does not intersect with the imaginary axis and it will lie totally on the left half of the S-plane. Now to understand all these steps, let us solve one problem. So for rule number 7, example 1 is g of s into h of s is equal to k divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 4 is given. Find the intersection point of root locus with the imaginary axis. So what was our first step to determine the intersection point of root locus with imaginary axis? To find the characteristic equation. So the formula for characteristic equation is 1 plus g of s into h of s is equal to 0. Now we will put this equation here. We will get 1 plus k divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 4 is equal to 0. So when we solve this equation, we will get s cube plus 5s square plus 4s plus k is equal to 0. So this is our final characteristic equation we are getting. Now using this characteristic equation, we have to construct the Routes array. Now second step is to construct the Routes array using this characteristic equation. So first we have to write here highest power of s given in the characteristic equation, that is s to the power 3, then we have s to the power 2, then we have s to the power 1, and last is s to the power 0. Now we have to find out the coefficient from this equation. First one will be a0, second is a1, then a2, last is a3. In this row of s3, we have to write all the even coefficient, that is a0 and a2. So here we will write 1, then 4. In the s to the power 2 row, we will write all the odd coefficient, that is a1 and a3. A1 is 5 and a3 is k. Now we have to find out s to the power 1 row using this s to the power 3 and s to the power 2 row. So first term here will be 5 into 4 is 20. 20 minus k divided by 5, and next term will be equal to 0, and first term in the s to the power 0 row will be equal to k. Now in the third step, we have to find out the k marginal, that is value of a which creates one of the rows of Routes array as row of zeros except s to the power 0 row. So to find out the marginal value of k, we have to make one of the row of Routes array as row of 0 except this s to the power 0 row. So we have to make this s to the power 1 row as row of zeros. Okay, so for this we have to take this 20 minus k divided by 5 equal to 0, then only this row will become row of zeros. So to find out the marginal value of k, we have to put 20 minus k k divided by 5 is equal to 0. K marginal equal to 20 we are getting. Now, next step is to construct the auxiliary equation using coefficient of a row which is just above the row of zeros. So, this was our row of zeros, that is s to the power 1 row is our row of zeros. So, we have to take this s to the power 2 row to form the auxiliary equation. So, from the s to the power 2 row, the auxiliary equation will be 5s square plus k is equal to 0. So, our fourth step is to form the auxiliary equation A of s, which is equal to 5 of s square plus k is equal to 0. Now, we have to put the marginal value of k in place of this k. So, this equation will become 5 s square plus k marginal is equal to 0. So, when we put here 20, we will get s square is equal to 4. Fifth step. What is our fifth step? The roots of this auxiliary equation A of s is equal to 0 will be the point of intersection of root locus with the imaginary axis. So, from this equation, we will get s is equal to plus minus j2. So, this is our intersection point of the root locus with the imaginary axis, which is equal to plus minus j2. Now, since here we are getting k marginal is equal to plus 20, which is a positive value, that means this point is a valid intersection of root locus with the imaginary axis. So, hope you have understood the topic. Thank you very much for watching and please do subscribe my channel for more updates.